Hey everybody, welcome back to JTS Cards. Been a few days since the last time I posted something, but pretty excited to have y'all here. So what we're gonna do today is a 2024 Topps Series 1 hobby box. A lot of you have watched me open some of these, and you'll know that I haven't hit the mother load yet on it, and that's all right. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, you know, we're just supposed to have a good time. So let's go ahead and open up some stuff here. And hey, I'm working on my setup over here. So for those of you who know, I don't know, starting out bare bones and just trying to have a good time playing around with my setup here. So for those of you who've never been here before, thank you. Thank you for coming out. Thanks for joining me. JTS Cards, we just try to have fun. We look for anything that's sparkly. I mean, that's pretty much what it comes down to. So if it's sparkly, it makes us pretty happy. So I'd love it if you commented below and told me about any hits that maybe you've had out of Series 1. That would be pretty awesome. Just knocking cards all over the place here. That's kind of the joy that I get out of what I do here. Just knock cards all over the place. And yeah, you know, super fun. Just a shout out to Hitman and to Tri-City Pulls. They've, you know, brought a lot of you into the JTS Cards world, and you know, that makes me super happy. I'm just really appreciative. So ordered some of those big league baseball cards, so kind of looking forward to seeing if I can find a Hitman or a Tri-City Pulls. That would be super awesome. Well, here we go. You know, if you've been here before, you know I miss cards. So, definitely want you to keep a lookout for stuff. Let me know what I miss. There were a few cards I was going to show you. Oh, well, I've set them aside, and I don't want to get up in the middle of all this. So, looks like we got a parallel here. Brendan Rodgers. Well, you know what? I think these are the ones that are numbered to 2024, right? Yep, 359 of 2020. Hey, I hit my own bounty. There is no bounty. So yeah. So I am getting ready to do some live stuff. Kind of excited about that, and hopefully you'll join me for that. Remember everybody that. You haven't been here before. The sound is terrible. The lighting's terrible. The host is the worst. And again, we just look for shiny cards. Shiny is awesome. Oh, you know what? Oh, no, I'll do that in a second. Still testing out my little setup here. Trying to see if I'll be able to do some live stuff here. What? Oh, that's weird. I was looking at that so quickly. I thought that was something on the card. It's his foot. Pretty funny to me. All right, here we go. Got one of the blueprints, Mike Trout. I do like these blueprint cards. I'm gonna set that off to the side over here. Woo! Knocking those cards. Need a new deck. All right, Pete Alonso, Bobby Witt. Cincinnati Reds. What is this one? Okay, it's one of the shiny ones. Oh, you know what? It's shiny, so look, it's shiny. Pretty cool, huh? Made that myself. Pretty excited. So, I love that picture. I think it's one of my favorite pictures from the series. I want to put him in my regular cards. It's going to go over here. All right. All right. I am trying to see. I thought that this series had, like, you get the gold on the top of the tops, and that was, like, the SSP or something. So I've probably already missed it if it went by, just because that's what I do. Oh, another one. Sean Murphy. Set Sean over to the side. And Max Muncy and Jacob DeGrom. Right. I know we have this kid, the... I actually don't think I have this one yet. I've got a bunch of some of these, but I don't think I have this one yet. So I will set Ken aside. Oh, you know, while I'm at it, I should fly through these real quick and just see if there's a one-of-one on the bottom of any of these cards because they forgot to stamp them. Nope, none there, none seen. And we'll do the same thing. Gotta turn it this way, a little easier. All right, we're looking for them to have messed up and given us a 101. It's the Riley Green. Set Riley off to the side here. All right. Nothing too amazing. Ow, just like cut my finger on a card. That was super fun. All right. Whoa, that was a tough one. Let's see if there's anything in this pack here. Right. The green. Ronald Acuna Jr. Outfield. Put him over in a little pile of happiness over there. Trent Grisham. No longer a Padre. Looking for those one of ones. I just don't even really know what I'm looking for other than the fact that I think there's a 1/1 in gold right there. And, yeah, I think it would be pretty hard to find. And if you don't know the whole story, Top shipped these cards out without stamping the one of ones, so they want you to send them back. And then if you send them back, they will stamp them for you. And they will also give you some sort of credit. I was told it was $150, but I do not have a verification on that. So I'm repeating third-party information. Forgive me if I'm incorrect. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed. Don't forget to like the video. Yeah, it's really up to you for me to be able to continue having fun and sharing this with people. A little shout out to Epic's Name Is Me. Always super nice in chat during rips. And quite a few other people out there that are just really good people during the breaks of other breakers out there, so I appreciate it. I do. Thank you for always watching. Okay. Here we go. Can we get something cool? So busy looking at certain parts of the card, I guarantee I'm missing things. Or not. Oh, that's the wrong way. We gotta look at this corner. The top. The top right. That's where we want to be looking. Alright, so again, if you've hit anything out of Top Series 1 that you want to share, I would love for you to send me a comment. Because I just have not had the greatest luck. And it's a beautiful product. You know, they did a nice job. I get it. It's a nice product, but hasn't really done much. So Pete Alonso and Brandon Marsh, you know, and I also know that you can't have every series of cards be about the big hits. I get it. You know, sometimes you just want to open up a pack of baseball cards, and that's okay. There we go. There we go. That's better. All right. Set these here. This. Oh, we got a number. 65 out of 70. Clayton Kershaw. Wow. On a blueprint that is, oh, that's my phone. I've never seen a numbered blueprint. So I guess that's the parallel there. So. All right, Clayton, thanks for showing up. Appreciate that. And no 101s there. And no 101s there. Okay, looks like we got what, about 8 packs left. That's, at least there's a lot of packs in a hobby box. Makes it a little more fun. Kind of getting tired of some of those that come with one pack. Like, man, First of all, they're extremely expensive, but man, your chance of hitting something is pretty rough. Trey Cabbage. Never heard of Trey Cabbage. I thought I had seen everyone's name from baseball this year, so obviously I don't know what I'm talking about. But if you've ever watched my channel before, you know that that's the whole point. I don't know what I'm talking about, and I'm just looking for things that are really cool looking. That's what I do. So if you enjoy that as well, and you don't know everything there is to know about baseball cards, you can learn with me. When I find stuff that's different, I like to point it out, and I like to get excited about it. For me, that's the fun part about ripping cards. So, or, well, at least open packs of cards. All right. And 101 check. This will be the bottom left. Looking for a 1/1 in gold. Nope. Nope. You can't say we didn't try, though. Well, let's see. Also, a lot of you probably are like, oh, should probably put those cards in a sleeve right now. There's some that I do once in a while, but I wait till after I open all this stuff to do that. I mean, I tend not to drop too many cards. I mean, I do, but like not a lot. I have a cool Grand Gamers. It's red on the outside. Some of you may have seen that video. That was pretty cool. Roberto Clemente. Right. And 101 check. Check one, check one, check one. 101 check. Nope. All right. Moving on. Thought that packed up a little thicker, but... I don't think it did. I think I'm just wrong. Ryan Mountcastle. Oh, maybe it was thicker. Trey Turner. That's pretty nice. I wonder if that's a numbered card. Major League material. The memorabilia contained on this card is not from any specific game event of the season. So he mailed them a pair of his underwear. And they cut it up. That's cool. Nice. We got some of Trey Turner's underwear. I mean, if you want to buy that from me, if you like Trey Turner enough to want his underwear, I will absolutely take care of you. That's not a problem. I will hook you up on that. So far, as you can tell, from the things I've seen, we are not killing it. That's okay. That's okay. Oh, that's pretty neat. I love these 35th anniversaries. I think the design is really cool. I think they did a nice job. Not numbered, but I would like to try to collect the entire set of the 35th anniversaries. That would be probably pretty hard to do, but I actually have no idea how many are in that, so... Maybe there's like 500 of them. That would not be fun. And I'm definitely not going to... Yeah, don't want to say definitely. I was going to say I'm definitely not going to open enough packs to try to find those. Yeah, I might. So, ooh, yeah. Julio Rodriguez. All right, let's see here. 101 check, check one, check one, check one. Just waiting for that one time that I actually see a gold one of one, and I'm like, that would be awesome. All right, let's see. Let's go. Let's go. I love the fact that some of you will message me and or comment and be like, hey, man, just so you know, you missed like 140 rookies, and I'm like, I did? I mean, no. I usually see it. I go back through these cards at the end just to see what I missed. The base cards, I think I told... Yeah, I'm going to keep telling you. Hold on. So, when I have a lot of base cards from a set, like this, right? Oh, you can't even see it from there. So, what I do is I take some like heat shrink stuff, I pop, it's a bag. I pop them in the bag. And then I just put a little bit of heat to the plastic and it just goes and it sucks right to the cards. So, I mean, these cards aren't for like grading or anything. I have a lot. And you can see that the plastic just pops off here. You can just rip it. But that way I give these to kids. That way they have some cards to open. And, you know, these are nice. I mean, they're Bowman Chrome cards. I've got a lot of different kinds that I give out. So anyway, that's what I do with all the base that I'm not going to use. It's not worth trying to sell them, and I'd rather have some kids open them and just have a good time, you know. And I don't take out all the good cards. There's a lot of parallels in those, just things that I'm not necessarily interested in, Fernando, and I give them to the kids. Let them have fun. I've said it before, every kid, boy, girl, doesn't matter, just should have a good time opening cards and enjoying the hobbies. These are our base cards. It's a lot of base cards. So you can see in the upper camera up there, that's a lot. That's the thickness of a pack. So yeah. All right, let's do this one. And if you haven't hit the like or the subscribe, now would be the best time. It's actually probably the last time before the video is over. Post your polls. Don't think you want me posting on this one, Tops. Okay. Let's take a look here. Mason Wynn. Corey Seager. Sonny Gray. And Emmett Sheehan, or Emmett. Oh my God, we got a Judge Auto. All right, hey, thanks a lot. Like and subscribe to the channel. I'll see you soon. Take care.